Welcome to the Man of Recaps. This is Man of Steel. It starts with Russell Crowe as an alien climate change scientist trying to convince the alien Congress that global warming is real. Unfortunately, General Zod comes in for a military coup. Russell Crowe escapes on one of the flying dragons from Avatar. He takes a swim in the birthing pits where he steals the skull. That's the codex that has all of the Kryptonian genetic information on it. And he downloads it into his baby. And he sends his baby off alone into space because apparently there were no family-sized spaceships available. General Zod manages to kill him, but then he's captured, his coup has failed, so they send him and his cronies off into the Phantom Zone, like a black hole prison thing, which works out really well for them because global warming was real and Krypton explodes. The baby makes it to Earth, where he's taken in by the Kents and raised as a good old Kansas boy. He occasionally uses his superpowers to save people, but Earth Dad's like, hey, you can't be doing that because the world's not ready for a Superman yet. In fact, even if there's a tornado about to kill me, don't come save me, just let me die. So Superman spends his days working odd jobs as a ridiculously ripped drifter. Now meet reporter Lois Lane. She's in the Arctic because the military found some sort of spaceship there. Superman decides to check it out, and he's got the key that fits. Luckily on Krypton, it's one size fits all. So he flies it off and meets the hologram of his space dad, who gives him the family heirloom of the super pajamas. And if you don't know Superman, he somehow gets his powers from Earth's young yellow sun, and that makes him basically invincible and allows him to fly. Now Lois was also investigating the spaceship, and she gets attacked by the girl robot from Wall-E. So Superman had to save her, and she wants to write an article about the super hot alien dude, so she uses her reporter powers to track down Clark Kent, and he's like, hey, please don't expose me to the world, and she's like, okay, I won't. Unfortunately, just then, a UFO shows up that basically exposes him to the world. They want to trade Superman in exchange for not destroying Earth, so Superman turns himself in, and evil hot super chick comes to pick him up and is like, hey, we also want Lois Lane, because she's there for some reason. They bring them to General Zod, who escaped the Phantom Zone, and his plan is to destroy Earth and use the Codex in Superman's blood to repopulate Krypton. Superman can't stop them right now, he's super weak, because he's not used to the Kryptonian atmosphere on the ship. Luckily, he gave his alien USB drive to Lois, who plugs it in and meets hologram of Space Dad. He hacks the ship and helps Lois escape, but unfortunately her escape pod is damaged on the way down, so he goes to see Superman, who's feeling a lot better now, and it's like, go save your hot Earth girlfriend. So Superman flies down there and does a classic Superman save. But General Zod goes down to the Kent farm because he thinks the Codex is in Superman's baby ship, and when it's not there, he flips the truck and gets mad, and Superman flies in and tackles him, does his classic move of just flying him through a bunch of stuff, and he's like, don't you mess with my mom! General Zod's mask breaks, and he's super weakened by the Earth atmosphere, which Superman spent a lifetime getting used to, so his friends come and take him away, and now they want to fight. He flies them into an IHOP, but they're super strong too, and the US military wants in on the action, but they are way outclassed. They get their butts kicked. Superman comes in and saves them, and that's how they know that he's a good guy, but anyway, the fight ends when they hit Superman with a train and retreat. Zod says to go ahead with the terraforming, so they put the one thing on India and the other one right over Metropolis, and blast this, like, gravity beam, which, as you can imagine, is quite destructive. Lois and Superman are like, hey, we have to crash my baby ship into their ship. It'll destroy it for science reasons, and luckily there's a scientist there to confirm it. So while they go to do that, Superman flies to India to destroy the other gravity thing. You know the toy where you make your handprint and all the metal pins? He has to fight one of those, and long story short, beats it by flying into it. Lois has to turn on Superman's baby ship, but she can't figure it out. Luckily there's a scientist on hand who knows you just have to smack it real hard, and that turns it on, and they go, and they crash the ship into the ship, and boom, Lois flies out the back. Luckily Superman's there to save her, and the rest of the ship gets sucked back into the Phantom Zone. So now we saved her enough times, they're allowed to make out, and Lois's Earth friends are these incredible actors, by the way, but General Zod lived, and he is super pissed. They have a fight where they basically crash through a bunch of buildings, and then he's like, no more fooling around, it's super pajama time, oh yeah! So they fly around, reenacting the Smith fight from the third Matrix, and then they reenact the Bowser fight from Super Mario 64, but in the end, Superman gets Zod in a headlock, and Zod's gonna, like, kill some civilians, so Superman has no choice but to snap his neck. Oh, he killed him. Wow. But anyway, the day is saved, except that Metropolis is mostly destroyed, and Superman decides to get a job as reporter Clark Kent, and Lois is like, yo, you know those glasses aren't fooling anyone, and that's how Man of Steel comes to an end.